from Nashville and Hollywood. Morgan number two's 30 Second Skinny.
Maren Morris is getting close to her March due date, but she says she'll miss being pregnant.
I will miss being pregnant because it's just crazy that your body is like capable of doing this. So I think that's the most surprising thing is like how much I would actually like it.
Lauren Elena shared the track listing for her upcoming EP dropping on March 6th. It will include her songs Getting Good and Ladies in the 90s. Brantley Gilbert has a pretty simple message to improve our relationships.
You know, I feel like God gave us the tools to be supportive of one another and to love one another and get along and be productive in life together. I think it starts with us. And I think a lot of times these days we spend too much time focusing on other people to take the first step. You know what I mean?
I'm Morgan number two. That's your skinny.
Wendy, she was from Virginia. She's on American Airlines flight from New Orleans to Charlotte, and she reclined her seat back. The guy behind her was in the very last row of the plane, so his seat is up against the wall. He doesn't have the option to recline back. He was annoyed, so he started hitting her seat obnoxiously. So she started filming him. The video went viral. She says that she told the flight attendant, we know this is true. She told the flight attendant, this man is hitting my chair, and the flight attendant took the man's side. She has since been fired for taking the man's side. Then now the woman wants to sue American Airlines and the guy. She feels like now it's like just gone too crazy. But I don't
know. Why is she suing though?
That's the part I'm confused by because what is she going to get? But she just.
But why is she suing?
Because the flight attendant told her that she was in the wrong, but she wasn't. And now it's all out there in the public and it's this big thing, even though she's the one that took the video. But I think she feels like since the flight attendant didn't take her side, that she has now the right to sue American Airlines.
Is she saying she's injured? I think that's what I read, that she's suing because she says she's injured.
Oh, I haven't seen
from
that part.
This. Yeah.
Emotionally?
No, I don't know. The whole thing is nuts.
So this was on an American Airlines flight, but the CEO of Delta decided to weigh in and as to whether or not you were allowed to recline your seat back. And I was shocked by his response. He says the proper thing to do is if you're going to recline into somebody, you ask if it's okay first. Have you ever asked anybody if it's okay for you to recline your seat?
Well, I think that opens up the question of, do you ask if you bring on smelly food?
Oh.
Can I eat this food next to you? If the seat reclines, you get to recline it. They should stop the seats from reclining if they don't want people to recline.
Right.
But the rule is, whenever you raise up to 10,000 feet or 12,000 feet, they go, you can now recline your seats. They say that on the speaker. So that's when you get to recline your seats. But if they want to shut it down, I'm okay with that too. As long as everybody's given the same fair reclining option, they can shut it down. It doesn't bother me. It's not like it's that good anyway.
It's like
it's not like you're taking a load off. Right. I fly probably every week, at least once a week. And so I feel like this is kind of my wheelhouse to talk about. The seats aren't doing anything. That reclining is not making you sleep any better. If they don't want people reclining, they should shut it down. But because it can recline, you can recline as far back as you want. That seat will allow you.
Okay, and I have what she's suing American Airlines for. Defamation. Because the flight attendant took the guy's side, like I said, but also that flight attendant apparently gave her a warning that she could be arrested for creating a disturbance. What? What about the guy? He was the one beating on her chair.
Well, obviously, she didn't take his side.
Obviously, and that's why she's been fired.
Okay.
So she no longer works there. So that's the update. Heads up, there's a woman, or I didn't even know people did this, but if you have been a part of this scam or anything, you need to call the police. But there's a woman named Juliet. She poses as Juliet Parker, Juliet Noel, Juliet Gaines, and she reaches out to new moms on Facebook groups and says that she's a brand new photographer for newborns. And since she's new, she's trying to build her portfolio. So she offers to come take your baby's photos for free. And then she drugs you and tries to steal your baby.
Is this one of your things that you read on Snopes?
No.
This sounds like one of those things you would get in the email forward and you bring it in.
This is from the Pierce County Sheriff's Department. And they, like a woman, was given a cupcake.
I like she yells like, I'll know what the Pierce County Sheriff's Department is.
I know.
No idea.
You've heard of it. Well,
it's from the Pierce County Sheriff's Department.
In Washington. Okay. I just feel like this is valid. It's really happening. It's serious. Because this woman, she called the police after she felt like woozy and weird after the photographer gave her a cupcake. And she ate it. And really the plan was she insisted that the woman leave her house. She made her go because the cupcake didn't pass her out. It was supposed to. and it didn't. So then she called the police, demanded that the woman leave. And the police, like, already had a case, like, and figured out that something like this is happening. And now they know that's what she's doing, is that she was, like, posing as that to steal people's babies. So they know that there's other people out there that maybe this has happened to.
Did she steal any babies?
I don't think she's ever been successful.
Or is this just a bad cupcake scheme?
No, but she's tried to drug to steal babies. Look, the woman has been arrested. Okay. But they want to know if there's any other people out there that have been a victim
cupcaked.
Of her.
Cupcake for baby.
Oh, I got a cupcake last night. I don't remember any
serious.
Other night.
Stealing babies is real.
Oh, yeah?
I was over at Francesco's Bakery, and a night got a little out of control. Next thing I know, I had a cupcake. I was out.
Listen, the woman was planning to steal a newborn baby to raise it as her own. Scary stuff. What was that? Remember that movie? Identical Strangers? The triplets that... There's all the baby weirdness with adoption. You think it's real and they take your baby.
I like how Amy just says, remember that documentary? We should know exactly what she's talking about.
Three identical strangers.
There you go. That's a good one. Check it out. Today is Random Act of Kindness Day. So an easy way to participate in this is to compliment a stranger or compliment a coworker.
I don't know, man. People always feel like I'm hitting on them whenever I do that. Anytime I just randomly compliment
what do you
someone,
say?
It doesn't matter, guy or girl. They always feel like I'm hitting on them. If I'm like, hey, nice butt.
Okay,
yeah,
well,
it's crazy they think
maybe
you're hitting
just
on
say
them.
Like, I like your sweater.
Your hair smells good.
You have a pretty neck. I don't know.
I guess it's just the kind of compliment you give.
You can also treat someone to a coffee or, you know, randomly in line do that whole thing. And
that's always a weird thing too, though. I've tried to buy people stuff in line. I'm like, no, I got it, and they're like, no.
Do they think you're hitting on them?
I think just generally. People think I'm just hitting on them when I do stuff.
Yeah. Well, maybe you get an out. You get a pass on Random Act of Kindness Day.
Okay.
But for everybody else, participate. I'm Amy. That's my pile.
That was Amy's pile of stories.
Luke Combs, even though I'm leaving here, Bobby Bone Show. If you guys want to hop on, hit us up. 877-77-BOBBY. There you go.
The Bobby Bone Show.
Let's go talk to Jamie in Arkansas who's standing by. Hey, Jamie, what's happening?
Good morning. How are y'all?
Pretty good. What's going on with you?
I just rolled up to school. I'm a third grade teacher.
Oh, yeah? Where do you teach?
Just everything, third grade.
Oh, yeah. Where do you teach?
Oh, sorry. Little Rock.
Oh, well, shout out Little Rock. That's a pretty generic. Is it just Little Rock third grade or?
Don Roberts Elementary.
There we have it. That's all we're searching for. Don Roberts Elementary. All right. What can I do for you, Jamie?
Thank you so much. I was calling to ask you how your first Valentine's Day with your girlfriend was.
Well, so last week I shared what I did, and I've got a whole long story coming up in a couple segments that I'll tell you about something awkward we kind of got into on Valentine's night. But I'll tell you, I came home Friday after the show, and I'll share what she did for me a little bit. I walked in, and there was this big heart. And it was made of the things that I like. It was Werther's Originals, limes, packs of gum. And it was this big heart, because I love all those things so much. I ate entire packs of gum at a time. And there was a big heart there. I put the card that she made on Instagram where she compared. I can read some of this stuff. She knows that I'm from Arkansas, and I'm very proud to be from Arkansas. So the whole card was people from Arkansas. It was like, you have the accurate. Oh, here it is. You have the southern charm of Glenn Campbell from Arkansas. Yeah. You have the accuracy of Dizzy Dean, who played for the Cardinals from Arkansas. All these are Arkansas people. You have the on-screen presence of Billy Bob Thornton, the football inside of Bear Bryant. He's from Arkansas. The athleticism of Scottie Pippen, the grit of Johnny Cash.
Wow.
So she found all these famous Arkansans and wrote this whole card. So she did that. She got me a really nice Arkansas sweatshirt. There's a couple other things I didn't have in mind to talk about this right now. I don't have my notes up. But so that happened. But then we got into something, not into it with each other, but we got into something that night that was pretty awkward. And I'll tell you about that coming up in a minute. We have to do our draft first.
Okay.
But it was a really good Valentine's Day. She definitely didn't have to put in all that effort, but she put in a lot of thought. And it was good. It was really good. But Jamie, I know you got to go to school. So if you missed that segment coming up in two segments, I would encourage you to go podcast it. Because really an uncomfortable situation and circumstance for me that night. Really uncomfortable.
Well, thank you so much having me. And I'm so happy for you and Caitlin.
Oh, thank you very much. Have a great morning. Everybody at John D. Roberts, right? Is that the name of the school?
Don Roberts.
Everybody at Don Roberts.
Yeah.
Shout out. Jamie, have a good day.
See you later. Thank you so much. You too.
Bye-bye. I'll give it to you in a minute. It was to the point where it was cringeworthy.
Oh, boy.
What happened to us. I told Amy. Mm-hmm. Amy and I and Caitlin. Let me say this right. Amy, her son, Caitlin, and I went to lunch on Saturday, was it?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I kind of gave Amy a little bit of debrief from the night before.
It was awkward.
Oof.
But it happened to both of you guys.
Yeah, but she was okay with it.
Okay.
Like, she's way more chill than me in social situations. She's just, like, chill. I'm like, are you kidding me?
So, this is not.
I can't
even imagine how you I know how you react sometimes to things, and so I was trying to picture how you responded, but you're also with your new girlfriend, so you can't.
I responded the same way I would have responded with you.
That's good.
I was like, what is happening right now? So we'll talk about that in two segments. We do have our Bobby Bone Show draft coming up next. The Greatest Americans Draft. Amy has the first pick. Amy, do you know who you're picking?
Yeah, pretty solid.
You want to share it?
Oh, okay.
You don't have to, but you can if you want.
I mean, I'm pretty Abe Lincoln, probably.
Ooh, probably. Oh, but you're not completely committed yet?
I feel like I'm committed. And I'm going first, so it doesn't matter. So who cares?
You're going to declare Abe Lincoln right now.
Yeah. He's pretty cool. Probably one of the greatest Americans of all time.
Oh. With her first overall pick.
Not probably. He is.
In the Greatest Americans Draft, Amy will be picking Abe Lincoln next. I like that.
Thank you.
Like that. All right. Let's see. Who am I going to pick then? Betty White.
Oh, she's pretty awesome.
American.
Luke Bryan. Let's just say I got a list up here.
Wow. Okay.
All right. The draft. We'll do that. Coming up next.
Missed any of today's show or just want to listen again? Check out the Bobby Bones Show on demand on the iHeartRadio app.
All right. Time now for our Bobby Bones Show fantasy draft where, much like fantasy football, we all sit around and draft folks. Lunchbox won the last one. Morgan number two is actually out for the first time ever.
Wow.
No, not the first time ever, but I took an L on
this
one.
That's cool.
Oh, I didn't remember you ever being out of this. That's kind of
shocking. It was very rare.
L train.
She's on the L train. Sorry. Sorry you're riding the L train today.
I know. It's a bummer.
The Greatest Americans Draft will go around and draft a team, and then you, the listener, you get to go to BobbyBones.com and vote on the team that you like the best. It's all about the team. And Amy, you have the first pick overall.
I do.
And you drafted as your first pick
Abraham Lincoln.
There she is. Solid first pick.
Yay, Amy.
Scuba Steve is our executive producer, and he's wearing a referee uniform. You got the whistle in case any pick does not fit.
Yes, sir. And a flag ready to go as well.
Okay. It sounds like a lot. It's a lot. It's very extra to do both of those. But okay, Lunchbox, you have this second pick of the Americans draft. You're up.
Yeah, I think young and old all love this individual, the greatest of all time. American bleeds red, white, and blue. Garth Brooks.
Right, Garth Brooks.
Interesting.
Eddie, you have the.
Yeah, I thought Lunchbox would go with this. I mean, this guy, he's on our quarter, he's on our dollar bill.
I know, me too. I was hoping it would get to
Mr. GW, George Washington, man, yeah. Come on.
Solid. Raymundo. Greatest American Draft, your pick.
Martin Luther King Jr. Yeah,
that was my first pick.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay, now I need y'all to not
There
pick
are no
the
Americans other. Left.
They're all done.
Don't pick
Abe,
mine.
George Washington, and MLK were all my first round picks here. I knew I wouldn't get two of them. Dang. Now I have to pick. I definitely wanted to set the tone with a great American in history. Because there's a lot of entertainment folks I could have picked. Abe, George.
Like any other president, you get too controversial.
Yeah, I don't know anyone that voted for George Washington. So.
Yeah, I know. Abe Lincoln, vote. Nobody was fighting back then about there was no Facebook. You know.
All right, I'm going to go with... Dang, that MLK Jr. pick was the one I just thought it would be there for me. I had all my hopes into that one. You know what we should do? And I'm guilty of this, too. We should put a shot clock on this.
Yes, we should.
Just
yes.
So the referee has something to do.
Yeah.
Instead of just sit there.
Yeah, because Scuba Steve sits next to me in a full referee uniform, and he never gets to do anything.
Yeah.
What do you think? 30 seconds?
I think it's too much. I think 15 seconds.
Ooh, too close.
Okay, 20.
How about 30 for the first round?
Okay.
20-10.
Okay, let's do that.
Oh, wow, 10?
That third round, you gotta be ready.
That's when it gets hard.
Yeah, I was gonna say, the third round should be longer.
30-20-10.
Okay, well, I'm, you're on the clock right now.
I'm on the clock starting now.
Oh, you got an extra 30.
You got like
an extra 6 minutes.
And a half bones.
Who are you debating against for your... I mean, there's other...
Well, I just really want like a Benjamin Franklin or... You know, I'm gonna go... I get two picks in a row, don't I?
What about like
I'm going to go with a Thomas Jefferson who wrote the Declaration of Independence.
Sure.
There you go.
Probably not going to be the winning pick. Because he just doesn't have the pizzazz.
He's a founding father.
He just doesn't have the pizzazz that a Lincoln has.
Pizzazz.
Okay, so there you go. First round picks are in. Amy has Abe Lincoln. Lunchbox has Garth Brooks. Eddie has George Washington. Raymundo has Martin Luther King Jr. And I have Thomas Jefferson. All right, I'm back up again.
So now you have 20 seconds.
I have 20 seconds.
You're on the clock.
All right. Guys, we're pretty much out after the...
Stop. There's a lot of more. Americans left.
There's no more.
5 seconds.
Oh.
Okay. Wow, this goes
fast. I'll go Ronald Reagan.
That's a good one.
That time got you, huh?
I'm just scared. I'm scared, Eddie. I'm scared.
Everybody like Ronald Reagan.
I'm scared of that. I want to lose my pick. All right, Raymundo, you're up.
I'm going to cross over a little bit to entertainment. I'm going to do Mr. Rogers.
Oh, that's really a good one. I didn't even think of him. Wow.
I'm freaking picking vice presidents from 9 to... I'm getting that.
Dan Quayle.
I got
good one.
Okay, over to Eddie.
I'm going to go with Taylor Swift, Miss Americana.
Okay, good.
What do you mean? It's a great
thing. I mean, you do that one?
I love her, but she didn't make my list.
And so we won't start the clock until I go, so-and-so, you're up.
Correct, yeah.
Oh, okay.
Okay.
Well, you guys have good picks. I have crap over here. Lunchbox.
Yeah, this person, I think everybody watched her on TV for years. Oh. She's the biggest thing in the world, Oprah.
Right. Had her.
Amy?
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Oh, good one, Amy.
You guys are so good at this. My picks are terrible. I have a list of picks, and they are not good.
Well, now that Oprah's gone, I don't know what I'm going to do. Is it me again?
Yeah, it's you.
No!
You're back to back.
No!
And she's got how many seconds?
Well, I haven't put her on. I haven't put her on yet.
Okay.
Oh. Yeah, I haven't put her on the clock yet. I was looking at some... I have people like Jimmy Fallon on mine.
So that's good.
Amy, you're on the clock.
I mean, I don't know. People better know that he's the one that invented Amazon, and you know you all love it. Jeff Bezos.
Amy's scolding
or
our listeners.
Bezos, or how do you say it? Bezos, Bezos?
Yeah. Amy's scolding our folks.
I mean, yeah. Okay. That's my third pick. Thank you for
Amy's
Amazon.
Abe, The Rock, and Jeff Bezos. That's a good one.
Okay.
It's a solid team.
I feel like I should have put a woman on there, but Oprah was taken.
Mm.
She was the only woman in America.
Lunchbox. You're up, Lunch.
Yeah. This person has entertained your kids. It's the happiest place on earth. Walt Disney.
Okay.
Oh, Walt. Maybe still alive.
I don't know.
Oh, Walt? Frozen.
Oh.
That's frozen. Eddie, you're on the clock.
Okay, here we go. I'm going to go with a fictional character.
Ooh, out of the box. I love people that think out of the box.
How do you know that the fictional character is American?
Because his name is Captain America.
No! No!
Yeah!
Great pick.
Woo!
Dang.
Okay.
Referee, is there anything wrong with a fictional character?
I don't see why not. He is Americana. It's pop culture. I give it to him.
That's what I'm talking about.
Who do you have on your team, Eddie? George Washington, Taylor Swift, Captain America.
Beautiful.
You guys have some solid teams over
here.
Red,
white, and blue
I'm really happy with my team.
Raymundo.
I want to cross over into a woman, but I'm just going to stick with an easy one. Chuck Norris.
That's not bad.
American.
I mean.
All right. Let me go to
my
team.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I have all my people are from like 1300.
Who's on your team so far?
I've got Christopher Columbus as ship captain.
His name is Pedro.
my last one's easy. It's Tom Hanks.
Good one.
I'm surprised Eddie didn't do that. Or
I know,
Gwyneth
I had him
Paltrow.
On the list.
Yeah, I'm a real turd. Okay, let's go. Amy has Abe Lincoln, Dwayne The Rock Johnson, and Jeff Bezos. Lunchbox has Garth Brooks, Oprah, Walt Disney.
Love it.
Eddie has George Washington, Taylor Swift, Captain America.
Yeah.
Raymundo has Martin Luther King Jr., Mr. Rogers, and Chuck Norris.
Yeah!
I have Thomas Jefferson, Ronald Reagan, and Tom Hanks. So I got two Toms on my team.
Me too.
Look at me. I'm Tomming it up over here. You can go vote. We'll have it up. It takes us, like, how long usually to get this up?
It takes us about 15, 20 minutes.
Because she's not only most of the time playing the draft, then Morgan number two's got to upload, like, put all the data in the website.
And I got to give Eddie a minute to edit the video to add on there, too, so.
So, BobbyBones.com. Hey, I think, I hate to give anybody a little push here, but I think, Amy, you got, I like your team the best. Abe Lincoln, solid first pick. The Rock. I watched a video yesterday. I don't even watch long videos on Instagram or Instagram TV. I watched The Rock going back to his daughter's wrestling school because his daughter just entered wrestling school. She's 18 years old. And so she wants to be a wrestler like her dad, like her grandfather, like her great-grandfather. And The Rock goes and is like training her and training the other people at the wrestling camp. It's a great video. I was in for all 9 minutes of it. I don't know what it is about that guy.
Yeah, he's very, very likable.
Yeah, and he shouldn't be because he can beat me up. And I don't literally like people that can beat me up so easily.
He was just on, in January, Oprah's WW tour, that thing she's doing. He was one of the guests, and I listened. She loaded it on her podcast, and I listened to it, and it was so good.
Was it?
Yeah, and he had just lost his father, like, 4 days before. So Oprah didn't even know if he was going to show up. And she's like, he still came, and then he talked about that and why he came and the influence his father had on his life and how his father didn't want him to do wrestling at all. He said they were living in an apartment like in Florida and he was a kid and his dad was a wrestler, kind of not excelling at it, succeeding at like he thought he should. And he told The Rock, you want to be a wrestler? Look at our life. Look at our life. I have nothing to show. Don't do it. And then that motivated him to go be the best. And now he's like one of the richest people ever. Famous.
Yeah, I think he's the highest paid actor too.
Really?
Boy, yeah. Talk about a guy that pivoted.
Yeah.
You mean, there were a couple people that had done TV and movies after wrestling. I mean, Hulk Hogan was one. The Rock did some of that, but The Rock took it to a whole other level. And also, for a long time, he tried to lose The Rock and just be Dwayne Johnson.
Yeah.
But now, I don't even think The Rock is a wrestler first. Mm-mm. I think of The Rock as a movie star more than I do a wrestler. I guess I know he's a wrestler, but I've watched him more in movies and television than I ever did wrestling.
Yeah, and like he's like the only guy that can play like a tooth fairy. And like still come out on the other side and play a tough guy and like be all the things. Is he gonna run for president?
The video was real good. I don't know where it was or what I found, but it was him training his daughter who's 18 years old and is training to be a wrestler. And he went in and taught her and then taught all the other kids there too.
It's awesome.
And he's so big.
It's huge.
Like he's just, and he travels with that gym they build for him every day wherever he is. Have you seen it?
No.
Like when he travels on movie sets, they build this entire gym, his gym. Dang. And yeah, well, I mean, that's how he can be so big.
Right.
Yeah.
That's fascinating.
I'm fascinated with The Rock. Yeah, yeah. Me too. BobbyBones.com if you want to go over and vote. I got nothing to say about my team.
You're not proud of it?
Yeah, I just thought MLK Jr. would be there, and he wasn't.
Why did you think nobody would take him?
Well, I was only one spot from him.
Oh, that's true.
But I was kind of caught my britches down, as my grandma would say. But I got Thomas Jefferson, Ronald Reagan, and Tom Hanks. Well, yeah.
Those are good.
They are good. They're fine.
Yeah.
Luke Holmes, Beer Never Broke My Heart, Bobby Bones Show. Thank you guys for hanging out. You guys want to hop on 877-77-BOBBY. Scuba Steve, no issues, right? No flags?
No, we're good.
Okay, we're all good. All right, BobbyBones.com. The draft is valid. Go vote. Alexander Hamilton, which would have been pretty solid. I just don't know if everyone knows Alexander Hamilton's story if they didn't go watch the play.
Oh, Hamilton.
Yeah. Do you, Eddie, for example?
He was our treasurer.
Okay, but do you know why it's so important?
No, he just kind of, right. Our money system?
Yeah.
Is that right?
Yeah, basically. Okay. He was the one that was like, hey, you guys understand that if we owe a bunch of people money, that's awesome. Because they have to make sure that we stay alive because we owe them.
Oh, wow. Interesting.
And that's really how America became.
Crazy. Yeah, I didn't know that part.
It's, again, I had studied them in high school and college, but until I had went and learned the music and the story through hip-hop.
Yeah. That's how we should learn everything.
Anyway, however you learn it.
Thank you, Lin-Manuel Miranda.
But yeah, which I thought was pretty cool. The guy had the foresight to go, listen, wow. We should owe people money because people take care of people that owe them money because they want to get that money back.
Wow.
That was one. I just don't think that played as strong. Michael Jordan, Dolly Parton was one that I think we all missed on.
Oh, good one. Yeah.
Dang. Neil Armstrong, Tom Sawyer.
Oh, yeah. Neil Armstrong.
There you go.
Put the American flag up there.
Yeah, on the moon. One giant.
Yeah. One giant leap.
All accurate.
For everybody.
I had something awkward happen on Valentine's Day night. I'll tell you about that coming up next if you'd like to hear it. We'll do that in the next segment here on the Bobby Bones Show. Thanks, guys. A Valentine's dinner, my girlfriend and I, and it was like, okay, we're going to go out. And I got online and I ordered the reservation. It was like 7:15. And it was at a nice restaurant. I mean, it was fine. It wasn't like anything super swanky. It was like in a hotel. It was a nice restaurant. And so we go to this thing and we show up, and I don't think much about it. We get dressed up. We go to this thing and they're like, okay, you need to walk back to this room. And I'm like, oh, I must have got a super, like,
fancy thing.
Or even a little bit, I was like, ooh, I guess they recognize the guy from the radio is coming. Oh, okay. Which I'm so stupid for thinking. I never think that, and I'm like, oh, okay. So I walk back to the back, and there's 10 other people sitting at a table. It's like if a family of 12 were all sitting around a table. There's 10 other people sitting at this table. And I'm like, oh, look at that family right there. It looks like it's fine. They're like, here you go, sir. Here's your seat. And I'm like, what am I sitting with 10 other people for?
Oh, you sat at that table?
They put all 12 of us. I guess we had bought some special Valentine's ticket. And we sat at this table all together. So I sit down and Caitlin sits down. And I'm like, hey, are we supposed to be here with these people? And she thinks that's hilarious. Because she knows I don't want to sit with 10 other people. And it feels like a big hibachi. And I go, did you guys know you were sitting with... I said it right out loud to everyone.
I was just like,
did you guys know you were sitting with people you didn't know? And everybody looks at me and says, I'm glad you said it because we didn't know we were either.
So when there was nothing about that whenever...
No, I saw nothing about it.
Yeah, you just knew there was a Valentine's Day.
And that is not special. My vibe. And it just, I just want to sit on... I'm not an outgoing person off of the radio or off the stage. And I'm like, dear God, I'd like to have a private conversation. And so I'm sitting there. And
y'all were sitting side by side.
There was no room for us to sit across from each other.
Oh, my gosh.
We're sitting side by side, too.
And next to a stranger, yeah.
And so we're all sitting there. And now it's turned into a buddy event instead of a romantic Valentine's event. And so I'm like, all right, let me see what's going on with everybody. So nobody's really talking to each other. So then I got to be outward Bobby. There's two versions of me. There's outward Bobby and super inward Bobby. And outward Bobby's like, hey, what do you do? So I'm just like patrolling the table to find out who I have something in common with so I can have a conversation because we're all so close to each other. And so I go over and there's one of the guys that sings in that country group, Home Free. Do you know the, they do a cappella. They're like pentatonics, but country.
Okay.
You familiar with that?
Uh-uh.
Okay. So he sings in that group. And I think he's the bass guy because he talks like this.
You put two and two together.
Yeah. It was like, yeah, I'm here with my girl. And so him and his wife were sitting beside us. There was a couple who I'm not sure what they did, but they were married, but they met on Tinder. That's what I knew about them.
Ooh. Oh.
There was a guy who was about 60 or so who was a high school baseball coach. And then over to my right, I don't even know. This guy was like Forrest Gump. He had like 9 jobs. I couldn't quite pin who he was. So we're at dinner, and here was the thing about the dinner that I also didn't know. I didn't know we were all sitting together, but it was heavy on wine tasting, which was why everybody wanted to do this. I don't drink. Caitlin doesn't drink really that much either, but they poured 7 wines. You sampled 7 oh, wow. wines.
And it goes with the food.
And every time they would give a wine, they would give a lecture on it. It was like a TED Talk on wine. So they would walk in with wine and be like, this is level 68 now. Now, the grapes were fermented the best during the summer of Milwaukee's best. And I'm like, what is happening? And so I just said no thank you to any wine glass because Caitlin was only taking 1 drink of each because she doesn't drink. She felt guilty and would have like a little sip of each one. She had 7 wine glasses in front of her full of wine. Looked like a lush because she was just stacked with alcohol. They would walk out. They had a fish expert come in and talk about our salmon.
Fish expert.
And then the fish expert sat with us at the table and like wanted to be part of the talk. It was so ridiculous.
This is like a movie.
Yeah, that's
dude.
Like an
it's
odd
great.
Valentine's Day it
was,
situation.
It was a whole thing. They didn't bring you a check. I thought that you were supposed to pay there. I guess when I reserved it online, this is how clueless I was about the whole thing. I guess they took my credit card and put it all in then. So at the end, we're just sitting there waiting. So they bring dessert and I don't need that much dessert because we want to go get ice cream afterward. And so I'm sitting there and a couple people get up and leave. I was like, well, they must have got their check. A couple other people get up there and leave. And we're just sitting there. And I'm like, and I have to be the guy that goes, hey, excuse me, can we get our check? He's like, no, it was all paid online. You could have left 30 minutes ago. I'm like, are you kidding me? So the whole thing was a little clunky. She thought it was the funniest thing ever to see me uncomfortable like that. She made friends. She makes friends with everybody. And then we went and had ice cream, and that was it.
It's really funny.
Yeah.
But I really thought we were going to get a prime two-person table overlooking the city. Instead, we went to a 12-person family dinner table with seven courses of wine. They had champagne coming out. And for someone who doesn't drink, I think that whole ticket was basically the alcohol. Yeah. That's why it cost what it cost. Mm-hmm. But it was great with her. We had a good time.
You made some friends too, huh?
I didn't come away with any friends.
No numbers?
I think she did. I think she ended up following some people on Instagram. They followed each other back.
Oh, wow.
Oh, she makes friends with everybody.
Yeah.
She was, because she went back to school. She gets her master's in like a month and a half or so. And so she said that she was in class with a guy, and he had one of his dating apps up, and he's just swiping as fast as he possibly can, accepting everyone, not even looking at the pictures.
Oh, wow.
Where he's going, accept, as fast as he could. And she sees him doing this and goes, hey, what's happening over there? And he goes, well, I never get any matches, so I just swipe to everyone, wondering if I can get any matches. So if I say yes to everyone, maybe some of them have said yes to me. Oh. And so after they finished that class, she took him and took a bunch and rebuilt his profile with him. And she said all his pictures were selfies. She was like, girls ain't gonna like that. She took pictures of him and then got some of her friends from the class to take group pictures with him. So he looked like he had a bunch of friends.
Look at that.
And then he's got two dates since. He never had a match.
Wow.
And never.
She's
very, well, she's just very people. Mm-hmm. She loves talking to people, loves making friends with people. And I, on the other hand, when it's time to shut it down, because I'm so out all the time, when it's time to shut it down, I'm just like, all right, time to be a little private here. But it was a good Valentine's Day. As far as we just got to hang out and spend time together. We went and hung out with Amy at lunch on Saturday.
Yeah.
Any thoughts?
I loved it. It was the first time I had met her in person. Previously, I just communicated with her on FaceTime. And so it was cool to hang out with her for a little bit. I thought it was just going to be us, but then Stevenson, my son, we had some issues. So I had to last minute. I was running out the door and I was like, get your jacket. You're coming with me. Like, so it was kind of, he had to come. And he said he really liked her, though. He thinks she's very pretty. And, you know, he thinks y'all are going to get married.
Oh, wow. So.
Well, that's good.
Yeah.
Well,
he's normally spot on. But I thought conversation's super easy with her. She's very laid back, like really cool. So I'm happy for you.
Amy's son took his iPhone and was taking pictures the whole time.
Oh, wow. Documented.
Yeah. Just take it the whole time. Had it out. Just taking pictures of everything.
Yeah. So, yeah. I think when we left, like, I gave you a hug. I was like, I'm so happy for you. And I meant it. Like, genuinely, it's good. It's good. I like her. Good call.
You weren't happy before that?
No, I'm happy for you.
And this is what happens. People will send me notes, friends, and they're like, you look so happy.
No, I didn't say that.
And I'm like, it's social media. I am. But I always look happy on social media. Do I look happier?
Maybe you have an extra sparkle, an extra pep in your step.
Yeah, I tell you, that Valentine's picture that I put up of Caitlin and I, here's what people love on my Instagram. My dog and my girlfriend. Mm-hmm. They don't even like me. No, they don't even give a crap about me. There's a picture of us eating ice cream, and it has almost 100,000 likes.
See, people are happy for you.
No, people like my dog and my girlfriend. They don't even care. They just put them up there. Okay, there's your update. You guys can hit us if you want. 877-77-BOBBY. We'll come right back. American Idol was on last night. It was the premiere episode. Man, I tell you, and I know these people on the show, but I hadn't seen their packages before, and I don't see them when they go in and sing in front of the judges.
Oh, okay.
Because I'm out working with them, talking with them before. But this, the guy who's the garbage guy, the garbage truck guy, like, I got tears in my eyes watching that whole performance last night.
Oh, it was emotional.
So this guy, Doug, he drives a garbage truck. He had never sang in front of people. He only sings in the back of the garbage truck, which, by the way, is true, because I spent a ton of time with this guy before and after. Like, now I can say that I know these people.
Yeah.
And so this guy Doug, he's like, he lives in Mobile, and he's like, I've only ever sang on the truck. And so he goes in, doesn't know anything about what key to sing in. He's just like, I'm just here to sing. And so here he is.
I set out on a narrow way many years ago, hoping I would find true love along the broken road. But I got lost a time or two, what my brow kept pushing through.
So he's singing, and at first he's a little off, and the judge is like, wow, there's something here. So what Luke does, he goes and sits on the piano and goes, hey, man, try to follow me. Because they can see there's something there. He just doesn't know how to use his tool.
So here's Luke going to sit down at the piano.
I said, can you hit that note?
I can try.
I set out on a narrow. I set out on a narrow way many years ago.
That was awesome.
Hoping I would find your love along the broken road.
It was so good.
I have goosebumps listening back to it because it was so sweet.
And Luke to do that?
Yeah. It was good.
By the way, I love this guy, Doug. He's just, love him. Because he's, whatever you saw in the show last night, like salt of the earth, hardworking guy. Like where I come from, that's the kind of guy that you want to be around. And he made it. And they were like, there's something in you. It's not all the way there, but you sound good and we can kind of put you in the right spot. And there was this other guy, Arthur Gunn from Wichita, Kansas. And he was born in Nepal. Now, his real name, I think his name's Debesh. But he got up, and you don't see it coming because he doesn't speak the best English, and he's really quiet. And he did Bob Dylan's Girl from the North Country.
So if you're traveling to a North Country fair, where the wind hits heavy on the border lines, remember me. To the one who lives there.
He was so good.
Wow.
You know, it was a great episode. I didn't show up until like an hour and 10 minutes in. I was a little disappointed by that. But first episode.
But when you did, there you were.
When I did, here I was. But I appreciate everybody tweeting along and watching last night. They're doing such a good job at sharing the human stories of these people. There are good singers everywhere, right? You can do a show about good singers all the time. But they really are highlighting the stories of some of these. So another episode next Sunday night. We get to live episodes quicker because I also would tire of these after a few. Mm-hmm. So we do these, get to live episodes quicker. But it was a fun episode, and I appreciate everybody for hashtagging on Twitter. Because if you hashtag just Bobby Bones, my little head pops up, which is crazy.
Pretty awesome.
Yeah, but a great episode last night. I was really proud of everyone, proud of the judges, proud of the singers. Thank you guys again for watching and tweeting along.
It's time for the good news.
With Amy.
Tell me something good.
So there's this 89-year-old guy named David, and his wife died 13 years ago, but he still had the wedding ring that she had custom made for him all those years ago when they got married. Well, then it went missing. One-of-a-kind ring, gone. So he filed a police report just so they would know in case anybody turned it in that it was his and he could hopefully get it back. Well, one of the police officers that was working is also like a jewelry maker and decided, you know what? Where was the original ring from? And then so they started talking about it. He went and found the original jeweler and got the mold for the ring that she used for it.
Wow.
And then a local jeweler heard about it and they decided to get the materials and make the ring for free. And so between the police officer and these jewelers, they were able to give him an exact replica of the missing ring and they surprised him with it. Wow. And of course it was like super emotional and special because that's like the one thing he had from
How about
his
that,
wife.
That cop for having multi-skills.
Yeah, right?
That's crazy. There you go. That's what it's all about right there. A lot of our On This Day in Country Music History is about Garth Brooks. It slowly went from I would find all kinds of facts to pretty much every day Garth did something awesome. Now, all of them aren't about Garth, but here's another one that is. Here we go.
The Bobby Bones Show. On This Day in
Country Music.
Today in 1997, that's 23 years ago, Garth Brooks welcomed two fans with some awesome gifts after they became his 2 millionth customers. The couple were Melinda and Ricky Huffman. They bought tickets number 2 million on his tour. They were given a Chevy Tahoe and a Caribbean vacation.
Wow.
They were at the show, and Garth called the couple backstage and said, hey, I'm going to give you a vacation in the Virgin Islands or the Cayman Islands. And then he threw in towels, snorkels, underwater goggles, and a new Chevy Tahoe. Can you imagine you're going to a show and you get a truck?
Come on.
Isn't that crazy? Quote, I'm still waiting for someone to pinch me and wake me up, said Melinda Huffman. So from on this day, 23 years ago, they get a truck and a vacation from Garth. That's crazy. I'm going to play Garth now. Colin Baton Rouge, Bobby Bones Show. The song is only 2 minutes and 33 seconds long. Did you know that?
No, I didn't know that.
All right, Bobby Bones Show. Thank you, guys. Happening in this viral video. So what I'll do is I'll play you a sound. All you have to do is guess what the sound is, okay?
Okay.
So your options are going to be bullets ricocheting through a forest, a dad and his daughter recreating a Star Wars battle scene, or a chunk of ice dropped down a 1,500-foot hole, okay?
Okay.
So I'm going to play you the sound. It's from a viral video and give you options to pick from. This video has 2.2 million views on Instagram. Here is the sound. Okay, is that bullets ricocheting through a forest, a dad and his daughter recreating a Star Wars battle scene, or a chunk of ice dropped down a 1,500-foot hole? I'll play it one more time. That's so high-pitched, it kind of makes me uncomfortable. Amy, you make a guess. We'll come back on the other side.
Okay, because the father and daughter are recreating a battle scene or
okay.
whatever.
We'll come back after this quick break, and we'll get everybody's guesses, and we'll tell you what that is exactly. All right, that's next.
The Morning Show's official YouTube channel. Go to YouTube, search Bobby Bones Show, and subscribe today.
Bobby Bones.
So here's a video that has 2.2 million views on Instagram. This sound is what we're trying to name. Here it is. That is an uncomfortable sound to me. Does it make you like squint your eyes?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's either bullets ricocheting through a forest, a dad and his daughter recreating a Star Wars battle scene, or a chunk of ice dropped down a 1,500-foot hole. Amy, you picked?
The dad and the daughter.
The Star Wars scene.
The battle scene, yeah.
Eddie?
I think it's too obvious. I'm trying to zone out the bullet sounds, and I think I hear ice falling down a hole.
Oh, wow.
Yes.
Lunchbox?
I'm going with ice down a hole also.
Let me hear it again, Raymundo.
What's
it sounds
that?
Like a Coke bottle being kicked to the parking
right.
lot.
But then the is throwing me off.
Then Luke Skywalker fighting throws you off.
Like, I don't, it's like, it does. It sounds like rattling, but then
the answer is a chunk of ice dropped down a 1,500-foot hole.
Wow.
Mike, you have to explain this to me. The video is from a team of Princeton researchers who discovered the 2-million-year-old ice cores in the remote Allen Hills of Antarctica. This was the sound produced by dropping a brick of ice down a 450-meter borehole. What does all that mean?
They wanted to see like how deep it was, so they took that piece of ice and dropped it down, and that sound you're hearing is just it ricocheting off the side of it.
Oh, it's the ice hitting the sides
hitting
of the
side of it. So it's making that weird ricochet, it sounds like.
Got it. Well, there you go. There's another edition of Name That Sound from the We don't have a good name for this game.
Yeah, I could tell.
We try on a lot of them, but on that one, we don't have a sound for. All right, there you go. Dustin Lynch, Riding Roads, Bobby Bones Show. Appreciate that.
Key, just a lot of family time with the kids and my dad. And what about you? You and Caitlin have a good time?
Yeah.
The whole time?
Yeah, it was good.
I saw that she ended up like jumping in the pool for some reason.
Well, here's what happened. She is a huge sports person. Not just watcher, but she likes to play sports. And there was an Instagram story of her throwing a ball at 45 yards just on a rope.
Jeez, dude.
Just, right.
It's a great throw.
Yeah. Probably better athlete than I am, right?
That's hilarious.
And so we're playing catch with the football in the backyard. And we play this game called What Are the Odds? You ever play What Are the Odds?
No.
So what you do is you go, we always do 1 through 10. So you go, what are the odds you and I will play? You pour this bottle of water on your head in the middle of the floor, okay? So you go 1, 2, 3, and you both say a number at the same time, any number between 1 and 10. And if it's the same number, you have to do it.
Oh, my gosh.
It's the 1 in 10 shot, basically.
Okay.
So let's me and you play, right? What are the odds here that you have to stand in the middle of our studio and pour this water on your head?
Okay, ready?
Okay, so I'll go 1, 2, 3. And if we say the same number, you lose.
And you have to do it.
And you have to do it right now.
It's so fun.
But I'm not going
to
do it.
You lose. That's the game.
Oh, you want me to pour water on my head?
It's only a 1 in 10
shot.
Okay.
There's no way it'll happen.
But you can do it back to me, too, just to show listeners how the game is played.
All right.
So I'll go 1, 2, 3, and then you say a number. I'm just trying to predict the number that you're saying.
Okay.
All right?
Yeah.
1, 2, 3. 7.
Yes.
Okay.
Oh.
Right.
Woo! Yeah.
Okay, so I'll do it now, too.
Okay.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
1, 2, 3.
4.
1. Okay. Right. So it's hard to get a win, but her and I played, and the number was six. And I was like, what are the odds you jump in the pool while it's freezing cold and catch this football in the water? And so we go, one, two, three, we both at six. She's like, oh my goodness. By the way, it's on my Instagram story right now. It's all up for a few more hours. And so she had to jump in the swimming pool, freezing cold, fully clothed. Hilarious.
Yeah.
But she does it, man. You talk about someone that commits to her bets. She was like, she's like, do I have to do it? I was like, you tell me. And she's like, I have to do it.
You left it up to her.
I did. I left it up to her. So, yeah, no, she jumped in the swimming pool. It was pretty funny. Went to Trader Joe's again. Let me tell you about the samples.
I saw that video.
Here, I feel a little guilty when I take a sample. Because I walk up and they have fruit. They're chopping up fruit. You know who likes fruit? Me. I like fruit. And I walk up and I probably this is my mindset going into the sample. I probably didn't want fruit. But if I was sampled so hard and I was moved by it, then I probably maybe would have got one. And so, but I knew probably I wasn't going to. So then a little bit my heart was already feeling like it shouldn't be getting a sample. And is the sample for anybody or for anyone that's thinking about buying something? So I'd convince myself that it was so good, I would buy something. They were called Sumo Oranges. I asked. I was like, what? And so I walk up, and instead of just grabbing it and start eating it, I'm guilted so much to where I go, hey, so what exactly is this? I know what it is. It's fruit. And they're like, well, this is fruit. It's orange and pineapple. And so I grab the plate. And so as I grab the plate, I then have to have another conversation and go, what's special about this kind of fruit? Is there a special on? And they're like, well, it's a sumo orange. It's a tangerine. And I was like, wow, okay. So I get it. And never in a million years would I evaluate what kind of fruit I'm about to eat. But because I'm so dialed in, I don't want to think I'm just getting the sample to eat fruit.
Of course not.
I get it, and I take the plate, and I look at it, and I, like, tilt it and look at the fruit. And I'm like, huh.
It's orange, huh?
I was like, it's interesting. Huh. And I'm like, so about these sumo, what makes this a sumo orange? And now I'm having conversation.
All because of the sample.
You know, they want you to take the sample.
Yeah, they don't even want to talk to you, though. So just eat it and go.
Who cares?
I felt so guilty.
Yeah.
And so at this point, I wanted to give it back, but I already had it in my hand.
Oh.
And I'm like, okay, so I ate the first, the orange bite. And I'm not kidding. I look at her and go, well, you guys are right. That's a good orange. And I think they're either just happy someone's talking to them or wanted me to leave, one of the two. So I eat the other two, and then I do something I'm not proud of. I yell at Kaitlin. I'm like, Kaitlin, you got to come try this. We may need some of this. I'm so committed to just not being a loser at the sample counter.
And how many did you buy?
Well, I didn't.
Okay.
You didn't buy?
I know.
You just sampled?
Did you act like you were going to buy?
Well, I had, and I concluded my performance of the sample counter by going, huh, we may have to come back around to this. And then I just started some dumb conversation and walked off.
That's so dumb. The way you planned it all out.
But I just felt guilty. What's the rule? Can you just eat samples with no intention to buy?
Yes.
Within your heart, though, can you have no intention? Or is that stealing a little bit?
Well, but then sometimes, even if you have no intention, once you take a bite, you're like, oh, that's good. I maybe should buy it. I did that one time with hummus because the woman handing out the samples at Whole Foods, she was actually the creator of the hummus. So it's like sometimes...
Emma's like, nah, pass, have better.
No. Sometimes the sample people are not associated, and then the other times it's like this is their creation that they made in their kitchen, and now they brought it to you. And I grabbed some. I didn't want it, but I grabbed it.
Oh, you felt guilty to get it even. Mm-hmm.
And then I circled back around to a different part of the store where that you could drop off the hummus, like a different fridge, and I put it in there.
Oh, you put it back somewhere
yeah,
else.
Yeah, because I didn't want the hummus. I didn't want it. Hey, but it was her baby. Like, she was real proud of her hummus, but it just wasn't for me, you know? But I didn't want to make her feel bad. I wanted her to be like, oh, wow, people like my hummus.
We're leading different sample lives.
Right.
Amy doesn't want it and felt guilty. And I wanted it so bad and just felt guilty. I had no intention to buy it.
And Bones, my parents, they go to Costco around lunchtime and just eat samples. And they don't eat lunch. That's it.
I know, my heart just felt guilty.
Yeah.
What was funny, though, was I was just enamored with the samples and just was staring at it. And there was an Instagram. It may still be on my... Maybe not.
I saw it.
Where she's doing commentary.
She's laughing.
And she's like, has he never seen a sample before? He's just... consumed with the amount of options here at the grocery store.
Now I know what you were saying. You're like, huh, sumo oranges, huh?
Yeah, I was like, what about this?
So why are they called sumo?
What year would these have fully ripened? It was all ridiculous.
Person's like, I don't know, just eat it. Get out of my face.
Yeah, they literally don't care.
Being a single guy for so long has really stunted my grocery store growth. because if I needed something quickly, I would just go to the gas station. Like, that's how I grocery shopped my whole life growing up. Or I would just have it delivered to my house. I don't go to the grocery store. Why? That's why I don't cook for myself. I just cook too much. But now, in 2 weeks, I've been to the grocery store 3 times.
Oh, I know. I'm like, dang. I know what's happening to me. This is like Bobby's favorite pastime is going to Trader Joe's now.
I'm Martha Stewart over here. All right. You guys want to hit me up. You want to see that Instagram story of the, what's that? What are the odds?
The pool.
Yeah.
You can see it. For going in the pool, yeah.
Mr. Bobby Bones is my Instagram. Thank you, guys. Hey, we're here live today. If you guys are driving around on President's Day and you're like, hey, wonder if anybody's working but me. We're here. Do you know we had the option to be off?
We did, and you didn't take it?
I chose not to.
Oh, okay.
I just felt like...
Didn't want to honor our presidents?
First of all,
what is,
they
what
ain't
is
honored
it?
Enough. I felt like tomorrow, once everybody else comes back to work, because Mondays are always a little rough for us. We're like, weekend, waking up early again. I felt like for the service of our listeners, we'll be right back in the groove tomorrow.
Kind of like our warm-up day today.
Yeah, today. Yeah, but it counts still.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, President's Day trivia, we're going to do that. In honor of President's Day, here's some easy President's Day trivia.
Oh, boy.
So, these aren't super, I'm going to be honest with you.
They're not easy.
They're kind of easy, but they're not super easy.
Oh, great.
Okay, Amy, you're up first.
Sure.
Ask not what your country can do for you, but what you can do for your country. Pretty easy.
Yeah, JFK.
Whoa.
Am I right?
You're right.
Is there more to it?
No.
Oh, okay.
I just felt like pausing on you.
Oh, sorry. Okay.
All right. Lunchbox, to serve as president, you have to be at least what age?
Ooh. 35.
Correct.
Woo!
Eddie.
Oh, boy.
Who is considered the author of the Declaration of Independence?
Oh, of course. That's Thomas Jefferson.
Nice. You all survived first round. Amy.
Yeah.
In George W. Bush's name, what does the W stand for? George W. Bush. The W. George W.
I'm not going to say the president number in case that's a question.
What does the W stand for?
Oh my gosh. I feel like it's like William? George Wilbert? George.
Of course, that's Wilbert. It's a very popular middle name.
Sounds right.
Wilbert.
I guess I'm going to go with William. Oh, what is it? Wally?
Walker.
Wally?
Wally.
George Walker.
Why can't it be Wally?
We never called him that. We just said George W. Or we say W.
W.
Dub.
What was it, Bones?
Walker.
George
Walker. Texas Ranger.
Yeah, Luke Skywalker.
Lunchbox.
Yeah. Yep.
What president was shot in the chest in 1912 and continued to give a speech?
He's a bad A.
He was. What president was shot in the chest in 1912 and continued to give a speech?
Oh, 1912. That was around Garfield's time. Garfield.
It is Teddy Roosevelt, who was also a fighter. I mean, that was his thing. Very masculine.
How did that go down? Like, he got shot. He's like, excuse me. That hurt a little bit, but I'm going to keep talking.
He said, just a little congestion. Can I get a little Mucinex so I can continue my speech?
Dang.
Yeah, Mike, will you pull up the details about that? I'll read that back. Eddie, for the win. This is not the easiest.
Oh, boy.
Who was the first president to live in the White House?
Ooh.
Yeah, it's a little... Got to think about this one. Who was the first president to live in the White House?
Now, I don't know the answer, but I did recently go to the White House and saw it from a distance, from afar. And I remember thinking to myself, like, wow, George Washington didn't live there, but I think John Adams did.
You thought to yourself when you saw it?
Yeah, because I started thinking.
Of everything you thought.
Wow.
You were so full of crap. Were you listening to classical music too, Chopin?
I was like, he must have been listening to Chopin in there.
Shut
yeah,
up.
Give me John Adams.
Yeah.
For the win, is it John Adams?
Yeah!
We play Eddie's Mexican theme
for President's Day. I'm sure they listen to this in the White House, too.
Mm. Eddie, who's the president on the $20 bill?
20? President? That is, Andrew Jackson.
Correct.
Woo!
Nice. Who said, read my lips, no new taxes?
That's George Bush, Sr.
Like, George H.W.
George
Bush.
H.W.
Yeah, nice. Which president had been a successful Hollywood actor and made his film debut in 1937?
Ronald Reagan.
Nice. What is the name of the theater Abraham Lincoln was assassinated in?
The Ford.
Nice. Do you know that one, Amy?
No. I mean, I did now that you say it, but I wouldn't have guessed it.
What president played a saxophone on the Arsenio Hall show during his campaign?
Bill Clinton.
Mm-hmm.
Wow. Who is the oldest candidate to become president?
Oh, the oldest?
Oldest.
Probably, Garfield is pretty old, huh, Lunchbox?
Yeah, he was.
Yeah, Garfield.
Trump.
Oh, wow.
Became president at the age of 70 years old.
And before that, it was Reagan, right? Or no?
Probably. I'm not sure. There's a difference in oldest in office and oldest. I don't know.
Okay.
What do we find out about our boy Roosevelt here?
Teddy.
Oh, he had the speech in his shirt pocket.
And it blocked the bullet?
And it's a lot of it.
What kind of paper was he using?
It was wood. Did somebody say wood?
What?
He reached into his coat pocket and pulled out a bullet-riddled 50-page speech.
Crazy.
Holding up his prepared remarks, which had two big holes blown through each page, he continued, "Fortunately, I had my manuscript, so you see what I was going to make, a long speech, and there's a bullet. There is where the bullet went through, and it probably saved me from going into my heart.
That is
the bullet
nuts.
Is in me now, so I cannot make a very long speech, but I will try my best."
No.
And
you
they took
to
him
to
the hospital afterward. No, he finished the speech and then went to the hospital.
That is crazy. Mm-hmm. The bullet is in me now. Why is not that not a quote that we all say all the time?
The bullet is in me now.
Forget that. I should go on, but the bullet is in me now.
Read my lips. Get rid of that one.
Read my lips. The bullet is in me now. That's funny.
That's crazy.
How many living presidents are there right now? Amy, go try this one out for size.
Gosh.
Just talk through them.
Okay. Obama's alive. George Walker.
Obama is the youngest alive at 58. Go ahead.
George Walker Bush is alive.
Yep, at 73.
Mm-hmm. Bill Clinton's alive.
At 73. Those are the three youngest alive.
Well, Donald Trump's still alive.
Who's older than George W. Bush.
Crazy.
Mm-hmm.
Who else is alive?
One more.
Think of him. He's in the news a lot.
Garfield.
No, he's not. It's
he's in the news.
He's in the news a lot.
Jimmy Carter.
Yeah.
Boom.
He's still alive. Yep.
He's in the news because he keeps getting sick.
Yes. Yes. This is true.
He's 95 years old.
So how many is that?
Five. Do we say everything we needed to say in this segment? I didn't say anything we wanted to get back to?
All right.
Just making sure. Holding it down over here. Happy President's Day to everybody. But is that really a thing? Do you say that? Do you go and you see your buddy you're like, "Oh, Chuck. Happy President's Day, bud."
Never.
Oh.
No.
Okay. And shouldn't we get off the day after the Super Bowl instead of this day?
You would trade this one for the Super Bowl?
Or just
for
put the Super Bowl the Sunday before President's Day.
I would trade this day and July 3rd for a Super Bowl and an extra New Year, and like the 31st on New Year's. Like, that's what I would do. I would trade this day, President's Day, and July 3rd for the 31st of December and the day after the Super Bowl.
I know. They need to have a...
Reevaluate?
Congressional...
That's what we need Congress to do right now. With all the bullcrap happening right now, guys, we got to talk about this President's Day holiday.
I might actually get something done. They could discuss daylight savings and Super Bowl holiday.
Mm-hmm. Let's do Garth Brooks, Blake Shelton. Here is Dive Bar, Bobby Bone Show.
Turn that...